Juan Mexico. He brings a record of 12-0 with two draws. 8 of his 12 victories by KO. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the undefeated challenger, Tomas Rivera. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the white, trimmed with blue, also weighing in at 104 pounds. He comes to us from Ponce, Puerto Rico, also with an undefeated record of 21-0, 16 KOs. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the undefeated WBO mini flyweight champion of the world, Alex El Nene Sanchez.
So we are ready for round one. This is the little guys, but this is where there's a lot of action, and we've got, believe it or not, at 104 pounds, a big banger here in terms of his knockout ability, the champion, Alex Sanchez.
I don't know if this speaks for his personality, guys, but back home in Ponce, Puerto Rico, Sanchez works at a funeral home as an embalmer. I don't know what that says about the guy, but he, you know, when he
why is he nicknamed El Nene, the baby? Why isn't he nicknamed the embalmer? I mean, that's a perfect nickname.
Seems that it's going to be a very interesting matchup because these two guys are very undefeated guys. They're very well-skilled fighters, very talented, and it seems that Nene's opponent is boxing. He's on his toes, and Nene, of course, is going to try and come out with that knockout punch, but he should be careful because this guy is a banger.
Tomas Rivera's last fight, June 5th, a third round knockout of Jose Robles in Mazatlan. He is going down in weight for this fight, down to 105. So he normally fights up at the higher weight limits, coming down. How do you think that will affect him, Oscar?
That can play a big factor in this fight. Coming down to weight, coming down to Nene's weight, can play a big factor because it takes out energy in the later rounds. Of course, these guys are going 12 rounds. If they were to go into the 10th, 11th round, it's going to play a big factor. He can get tired, exhausted, dehydrated. We have to see what's going to happen in this fight.
Alex Sanchez in the white trunks, the champion, known as Nene, as you heard Oscar De La Hoya refer to him. He is a fighter who won the vacant WBO title in December of 93 with a one-round KO of Orlando Malone. He has defended it successfully 4 times. Last time was his first fight in the United States, his first big fight. He appeared on pay-per-view. He needed the 12 rounds to dispatch Rafael Orozco. He won by decision, and he said in that bout that he felt pressured by the by that situation, first fight in the United States, and perhaps now he's a little more accustomed to it, Rick.
Well, Rivera, I right now looks about as stiff as you can be. I mean, I'm almost holding my breath for him. He appears to not even be breathing. He's so stiff. And the one thing to keep in mind about Sanchez, he could be standing 3 feet away from you and hit you with a punch because he loves to throw lunging punches. That's how he knocks out his opponents.
Rivera considers himself a boxer. He says he must box intelligently against Sanchez to win this fight.
I believe that's the only way he can win. Rivera is seems as if he's a good boxer. Now Nene is a good banger. He can hit with either hand, left or right, and he can knock you out with either hand. So Rivera has to be very careful. He did get caught with the right hand, left hook.
There's a sneaky little right hand inside by Sanchez. So for the first time, perhaps, Rivera feeling the power of Nene, Alex Sanchez. First of a 12-round schedule bout.
At this point right now, it's a filling out process. I mean, they do not know each other. They're trying to warm up. They're a bit cold, and they'll maybe step up the action in the later round, second, third round, trying to get things going here.
So a feel them out first round for these two mini flyweights, the 105-pound division of the WBO.
The crowd not too thrilled with that. Over the history and the years of boxing, you grow accustomed to watching heavyweights feel each other out and not see much action. It just seems in the past that the lighter weight fighters tend to come out and just start throwing punches. You think these two guys are in a major heavyweight championship bout?
Well, fighters nowadays, they're trying to play it smart. I mean, they're not just trying to go in there and bang each other out. They're not trying to just get knocked out. These guys are playing it smart. They're trying to feel each other out, see what they have, and later on, second, third round, fourth round, step up, and maybe we might see a knockout.
Are you ever motivated by the crowd at all, whether they're booing or cheering?
Most definitely, because when I was coming out for the Rafael Ruelas fight, all the fans there were booing me. They were against me, and that kind of motivates me more to do well. It, of course, adds more pressure to me, and I believe that's what's happening to these guys now. It's adding pressure. The fans are not appreciating that they're not throwing punches, but right now they're going to come out, and you're going to see some fireworks tonight.
Well, they just saw a hot 12-rounder before this, and as I mentioned, that's going to be a tough standard to reach up to for all the other guys to follow.
Everybody's spoiled.
Thomas Rivera is the challenger. He's in the blue trunks, and Alex Sanchez, the WBO mini flyweight champion, in the white trunks with blue trim. Sanchez told me yesterday, I sat down in a nice chat with him, he said that he cried when Chiquita Gonzalez lost his fight last week. He had wanted to fight Chiquita, and Chiquita, of course, someone that he has grown up looking up to and everything, and he was hopeful that he would get an opportunity, in fact, to face off against Chiquita Gonzalez, who was, of course, stopped in seven rounds by Saman Sarchadaran, so that kind of threw a crimp into his plans there.
Alex Sanchez did want Chiquita Gonzalez for a very long time, and now that Chiquita Gonzalez got lost and got knocked out, it doesn't give him the opportunity to fight him now. It should have been a big money fight, and now Alex Sanchez has to look for bigger and better things.
Maybe Ricardo Lopez would be a possibility down the line. He mentioned him.
It's interesting because you certainly consider boxing an individual sport. It's not a team sport, but your destiny and the money you make is not in your own hands. I mean, if the big money opponent that you're dying to meet loses along the way, that really hurts you.
I'll never forget looking at the sick face of Evander Holyfield when he was over in Japan watching Mike Tyson get knocked out by Buster Douglas that night, because Holyfield had been next in line, and when Douglas took care of Tyson, that knocked a huge money fight right out the window.
You know how many guys are just hoping and praying that Oscar De La Hoya never loses? just so they can fight him at some point?
I have a long list ahead of me. A lot of fighters out there who want to fight me. I'm here, I'll be ready, always in shape.
You in shape right now for this broadcast?
Well,
you know, Rich and I are looking back and thinking, if we would have done one more sit-up. I think we will be by the fifth fight anyway.
Well, let's take a look. What we got here is Rivera moving forward and doing pretty well. He's throwing a lot of punches. He's actually been able to back Sanchez up in this fight.
Very surprised, because Sanchez does possess a big punch in either hand. And right now, his opponent is really just coming at him and trying to press the action.
Well, he's keeping the jab going. I mean, he's being active with the jab, putting it in Sanchez's face, and it doesn't allow Sanchez a chance to get anything off.
And Sanchez here will draw a warning for a low blow from referee Lawrence Cole. Sanchez having trouble reaching Rivera here in the early one. We mentioned he was at a 4-inch reach disadvantage. Now you see a nice left jab by Rivera, got right back out of range.
Beautiful boxing by Rivera. Sanchez, of course, trying to knock him out, working the body beautifully. Things are starting to heat up in this boxing match tonight. Ay caramba!
What we're seeing here, Oscar, is the same thing that we saw in the previous fight in terms of Mauro Lucero was taking a huge jump up in class to fight Juan Rodriguez. Now Thomas Rivera taking a big step up in class to fight Alex Sanchez, but taking the step up very gracefully and assuming the ability perhaps to win this fight.
Very interesting, because anything can happen in these matches. For Rivera does not possess that much experience, but on the other hand, Alex Sanchez has 20 fights, and he's getting kind of hit in this fight.
Let's go back and take a look at some of the action now in round number two.
Beautiful right hand by Rivera with a left hook, and Alex Sanchez, of course, being surprised by Rivera's punches right now.
And they came from long range.
certainly the key to keeping a little guy from getting inside is by having a jab that keeps them out of their range, so to speak. And that's what Rivera has been doing to Sanchez.
I believe now the key to the victory is using your jab. Jab can open the doors, and that's when you come back with your right hand, left hook, and that's when the knockout comes after your jab.
Sanchez is in an unusual mode for him, backing up. Could he possibly be trying to lure Rivera into something here?
It's very difficult to say because I'm very surprised. Alex Sanchez, of course, is a very powerful fighter, and he's moving back. He's letting Rivera move him back and press the action. I believe right now, hopefully, that Alex Sanchez is trying to warm up. He's a bit nervous, scared that this is his second time in the United States, trying to show the crowd that he is a strong fighter, trying to knock him out, so there's more pressure involved in his boxing performance.
And as you mentioned, he did feel the pressure in that Orozco fight, kept him from putting on his best performance. And so far, he's being fought at least on even terms, perhaps more than that, by Thomas Rivera, the challenger, who here is trying to utilize his reach advantage. Stick out the left jab and keep Sanchez away from him. Sanchez, though, is known as a guy who always comes forward, and that has not been the case in this fight. What we are seeing here is a chess match, Rick, which I didn't really expect to see in this fight.
Well, Rivera, again, really is not allowing Sanchez to get inside. I mean, you just keep flipping that jab out there like he's doing there, and then Sanchez can't move in. It's sort of like keeping the door closed, slamming it into space. Every time Sanchez tries to come forward, there's a little jab there.
Nice right hand by Sanchez. First punch of any real significance that he's thrown and landed in this fight. And a left hook to the body. I think he's beginning to get in punching range now. Cutting down the distance a little bit on Rivera.
Beautiful counter punching by Sanchez.
That's the thing. If you can't get inside and try to fight your game, then you got to try to bring somebody to you.
Sanchez now bringing the attack downstairs. Sanchez has got a nice style. You take a look at him in the ring. Very good technique. Keeps his hands up in a nice defensive posture. Moving his head a little bit on his toes, but he does boast that power.
I believe Alex Sanchez is a complete fighter. He can box, he can punch, he can stay in front of you, move his waist. Very good fighter.
Sanchez beginning to dip low and shoot that left hook to the body. Twice to get the two fighters to go to their respective corners with first three rounds scheduled for 12. It's the WBO Mini Flyweight Championship. Rich Marotta along with Oscar De La Hoya, Rick Garcia, Top Rank Inc. Promoting tonight's big five-bout extravaganza, I Carumba. Go to the corner now with the challenger, Tomas Rivera.
At this point right now, they're asking for the Vaseline to put on his face just in case he gets hit by a good punch and he won't get cut. Very surprised because they're not giving him that many instructions in the corner. They're worrying about getting injured, getting cut. To throw punches first, throw your jab, your right hand, be first. If he wants to go in, throw your punches first, box him, and you could beat him that way. I believe the key right now for this guy, for Rivera, is to box, and he maybe can win this fight like that.
Just try to keep Sanchez out of the end of his jab, you think?
I believe so, because right now the key to his success is boxing. Alex Sanchez does possess more power. He's a dangerous fighter. He doesn't box too much, and right now Rivera can box him, can win, and hopefully he can be smart and be victorious that way.
Well, they throw that Vaseline on him, and the referee made him take it off.
Oscar, how do you feel about instructions in the corner? Do you like to have a lot of instruction or very little?
It depends. It depends on the fighter. It depends on the corner man, because there's times that corner men do all the talking in the gym, in the training. They give you the instructions. You know what to do. Your fighter goes out there and has his game plan already. Now there's fighters that don't know what they're doing. The corner man has to tell them, you know, throw your jab, throw your right hand. It confuses the fighter. So for me, like my trainer, Robert Aguilar, takes his time. He does not say much, but we have our game plan in the gym, and we already know what to do.
And then, on the other hand, you have a guy, you have like Roberto Duran's corner, where there's always 15 guys screaming at him at the same time, all with different instructions.
And I have a feeling he didn't listen to any one of them.
We're in round four, WBO Mini Flyweight Championship bout. Alex Sanchez, the champion in the white trunks, began to come on a little bit in round three. Thomas Rivera enjoyed a good first two rounds, utilizing his own boxing ability. Two undefeated fighters in the ring. Rivera known more as a boxer, Sanchez known more as a puncher. Crowd calling for more action here in San Antonio. There were long lines today here at the Freeman Coliseum. It's a very good fight town, San Antonio. But if these fighters get it going, they will warm up very quickly. Nice little left hook put in by Rivera, and he follows it up.
I believe at this point right now, Alex Sanchez is warming up. He's pressing the action now. He's moving his waist. I believe it will take maybe two more rounds, three more rounds to maybe warm up and maybe hopefully get a knockout at this fight.
He's coming forward now. But as he's coming forward, he's not throwing much. Going to need to launch some of those big blows of his. There's that very quick left hook of his. It didn't land cleanly that time, but that's the kind he can get guys down with because it comes out of nowhere and it's so quick. It's like a cat striking out.
Well, they're clearly more active this round than any part of the fight. So I would assume the feeling out process is probably all but done.
One thing that has changed in this round, though, is we do see Sanchez beginning to move forward now more in this round. It was Rivera, remember, backing him up in the other round, but look who's coming forward now. It is Alex Sanchez, and Rivera is beginning to use this 20-foot ring more.
And, but you'll notice Rivera, the jab isn't keeping Sanchez away as much as it was the first three rounds.
Right. Looks to me as though Sanchez is beginning to take command ever so slightly in this fight.
He's gaining confidence. He already took the best shots from Rivera, and he knows that he cannot knock him out. And now he's trying to move in, press the action, and hopefully get a knockout in this fight. Throw more punches. What you're doing right now is you're not throwing enough punches. You have to throw more punches to win this fight. Beautiful left hook by Rivera.
That was early in the round. Later on in the round, Alex Sanchez was the guy who came on, though. At least on my book, I would have given that round to Alex Sanchez. Round five, scheduled for 12 WBO Mini Flyweight Championship. The champion, El Niño, the baby, Alex Sanchez. In the white trunks with the blue trim, the challenger, undefeated Tomas Rivera, in the blue trunks with the red. Sanchez certainly a strong favorite in this fight, but Rivera has acquitted himself very well. This is what you're seeing tonight so far is competitive, well-matched fights. This is what fight fans, I truly believe, really want to see.
I think that they misunderstand this kind of a fight, however, and want to see more action. But the key here is that because there's less action doesn't mean that these are not good fighters. They're both very well-skilled, but they're very smart. And that's why they're not getting hit.
When you have two fighters who are just standing in front of each other, not throwing punches and just looking at each other, those are two fighters that are well-matched. Very talented, very skilled fighter. So right now the fans are not appreciating this fight, but they are going to see some good action in the later round.
Well, they're not appreciating it, but they have to remind themselves they're not in the ring either.
Do you think, Oscar, that one of these guys could do something to really take control of the fight from what you've seen so far?
I believe right now Sanchez has to press the action more. He is more powerful. He does throw faster punches. He is more experienced. So I believe he has to move his head more, go in front of him, and just try to knock him out. Easy as that.
Yeah, when you have two good fighters like this, though, I think the key is who makes the first mistake. That's really what it comes down to, I think, is if somebody makes a mistake.
What I see here is Sanchez is trying to counterpunch him. He's trying to make Rivera miss punches and come back with his own punches, which can be a very difficult for Tyson because Rivera playing it smart, very smart, throwing his jab, boxing him.
This fight has been fought almost completely at long range. Nice shot by Sanchez in close that time. He got within punching distance, and I think Rivera felt that one. And a pretty good combination of punches by Alex Sanchez, the champion.
It's almost like an overhand right. It's like in between a hook and an overhand right. It's not straight over the head, but he connected with two of those.
Sometimes it's that kind of punch that you don't see too often that can take care of you. It's that one Oscar you knocked out Jorge Paez with. A little bit different looking punch.
Called a phantom punch. Nobody sees that punch, but you can feel it right in your glove.
Fans unhappy with the amount of action they're seeing is what we're seeing here between these two fighters. Basically, it's a chess match so far. Fight being fought at long range.
Well, the way to look at it is like a pitcher's duel in a baseball game. You don't see a lot of scoring, but that one run is going to be the difference in who wins and loses.
And Rivera is putting himself perhaps in a position where he could win a championship here. I'm sure he's not too concerned about the fan reaction.
One mistake by Alex Sanchez. He's waiting for that one punch knockout, which is very wrong from his part, from his corner. They're tying him with the body. They're trying to press the action because you can lose this fight. This guy's boxing you. He seems as if he's smarter. He's boxing. He's using his jab. And right now, Rivera, his corner seems as if they're ahead on this fight.
And that's some of the Felix Trinidad contingent in Alex Sanchez's corner. Trinidad's kind of own Puerto Rico right now. Oscar, you were down in Puerto Rico not too long ago.
Beautiful town, beautiful people, and hopefully after this fight I can visit Puerto Rico again because I enjoy myself. They love boxing over there, from the grandmothers to the little kids. It's a great feeling to be in there.
Oscar received the WBO championship ring in Puerto Rico as we come out now for this round six, scheduled for 12. Alex Sanchez, the champion in white. Thomas Rivera, the challenger in blue. What appears to be a close fight between these two. It has been a boxing match. Fans who saw a real slugfest in the first fight here tonight when Mauro Lucero and Juan Rodriguez fought to a draw for the Mexican lightweight championship. Perhaps a little spoiled by that opener. And would like to see a little more of that kind of action. But what we're seeing here is intelligent boxing by these two fighters in the ring. And certainly nothing approximating the slugfest we did see in that opener.
Alex Sanchez should press the action. Rivera right now is boxing him, trying to use his jab. And Rivera, of course, very intelligent, very smart, trying to box him. But Alex Sanchez should press the action more and not try to focus on knocking him out in with one punch.
Nice left hook by Sanchez. That's a very good punch for Sanchez, that left hook. Rivera has taken the punch as well, though, when Sanchez has landed them. Don't you think, Rick, he's hardly really bounced back a step or two?
That was the only one, I think, that pushed him back a little bit. It certainly, I think, garnered a little respect from Rivera, but most of the punches, that's the hardest one, without a doubt, that's been thrown in the fight, I think.
Sanchez marching forward, Rivera trying to utilize the ring.
Well, that's where Rivera's going to get into trouble, is if he allows Sanchez to get into his space, then that's a mistake for Rivera. In the early rounds, he would not let Sanchez move in.
I think if you let Sanchez pick up any type of momentum, he could be in trouble. And I think Sanchez having a pretty good round here.
Yeah, he is picking up the momentum right now.
He's really winding up with that left hook, both body into the head. Sanchez having good success here in the round.
I believe this is boxing at its best. They're throwing beautiful left hooks to the body, beautiful left hooks to the chin, good right hand. And these guys are just well-talented, well-skilled, and these guys work very hard to go down a great performance. tonight on this great card that we have tonight.
I agree with you. The two fights we've seen so far are at different ends of the scale, and you should respect this one as well as you do the first one.
Six rounds in the book. This for the WBO mini flyweight championship. The WBO, by the way, I think has really significantly improved its reputation in the last two or three years, where it was basically scorned when it was first came into operation, and a lot of people didn't want to see a fourth sanctioning organization. And I think we can all understand why. I mean, there's a lot of chaos with the sanctioning bodies in boxing, but if you take a look at what the WBO has done, it's with its list of champions, it's pretty impressive.
They got a couple of decent names, yeah.
You're one of them, Riddick Bowe, of course. Marco Antonio Barrera and Alex Sanchez, who stepped up, I thought, to Oscar in that round.
Of course, though. Alex Sanchez right now landing a beautiful left hook. He's pressing the action. He knows that he can knock this guy out if he lands a great punch. A left hook, either a right hand, whatever punch he can land, he's going to knock him out.
Do you think he can knock him out?
I think so, because Alex Sanchez is a strong fighter. He's strong. He may be small, but he packs a punch.
You talked about the WBO and the recognition it's receiving now. In fact, Oscar, you threw one of your belts away that belonged to another organization.
Well, actually, what happened is, of course, I did see Riddick Bowe throw one of his belts away. But what I did is I just handed it to him. I gave back the IBF. I said, thank you for letting me beat your champion, Rafael Ruelas. And I just gave it back to him and was very courteous about it and was a gentleman about it. And I'm going to stick to my WBO, which is the best organization for me in the world now. I believe class plays a big part in my life, because I'm not going to step down to anybody's level and maybe throw a title belt away. I'm going to tell them
garbage.
I'm going to tell them thank you. Thank you very much for letting me beat your guy. And, you know, it was great having your belt. It makes a great trophy in my house. And that's about it.
All right, we're in the seventh round of the WBO Mini Flyweight Championship. Sanchez and Thomas Rivera. Let me ask each of you guys how you have this fight in terms of the score right now. It would seem to be awfully close, I would think. Rick, what do you think?
Well, I had Sanchez winning the last round. I think it was even up to that point, but I think Sanchez took the edge in round six.
Very difficult to call, because Rivera, of course, is getting tagged by very strong punches, but Rivera's throwing more punches, not as effective, but the judges see that he's landing more punches consistently.
Sanchez, I think you can see now, is landing the more powerful shots between the two, and you can see there is a disparity in the power between the two, and that Sanchez boasts the greater punch. That right hand that he landed about 45 seconds ago was a real nice shot. Good little combination in tight by Rivera, as Sanchez goes with his back to the rope. Sanchez looking for an opening here, finding one difficult to come by, and Rivera's taking advantage of all Sanchez looking and opening up with his own combination. Good hard right by the champion.
Sanchez going with some combinations now, left and right.
Yeah, he's stepping up the pace here, moving forward very purposefully.
Alex Sanchez is a very strong fighter. He can throw any punch. He's going to land it, and he's going to hurt you.
Left-right combination by Sanchez, and he's now really enjoying a good round. Rivera landed some combinations early in the round, but they were not to the same effect as are the punches of Sanchez.
So we are ready for what we think is going to be a delightful...